If you're navigating, building and renovating in a bushfire prone area or on a property that has a bushfire overlay, you may have heard both about BAL ratings and about the Australian standards for bushfire design. So how do the two of these talk to each other and what do you need to know about them? We're going to cover that in this video. This video is part of our Rebuild and Build Better series. So be sure to like the video, subscribe to Undercover Architect's YouTube channel and hit the bell so that you're always notified when a new video is published. If you're rebuilding after losing your home to bushfire, or you're building or renovating in a bushfire prone area, then understanding the various codes is really essential for you being able to design an appropriate home and be able to construct it appropriately as well. In this video, we talk about the Australian standards 3959 and also how they relate to BAL ratings. Plus, we talk about rate of spread and ember attacks and what to consider when it comes to the design of your project and making sure that you can make it as resilient and resistant as possible. Hello, I'm Amelia Lee from Undercover Architect, and I help and teach homeowners how to get it right when designing, building, and renovating their family homes. In this video, I speak with Jeff Dau from Ember Bushfire Consulting. Ember Bushfire Consulting are a team of qualified accredited professionals in the fire industry, and Jeff himself, as co-founder, has over 28 years experience as a professional in the fire industry. He shares a huge wealth of knowledge and information when it comes to understanding the impacts that a bushfire overlay can have on your property and how you need to navigate building and renovating in one of these types of areas.
Now, can you just talk to us? We've got the BAL rating, so the bushfire attack level. We've also got the Australian standard 3959. How do those two things factor into it to each other and talk to each other as part of you creating a solution in a bushfire prone area?
Okay. So the BAL rating is a product of Australian standard 3959 construction and bushfire buildings and bushfire prone areas. 3959 is a methodology to conduct a site assessment first off. So it's broken into two parts. The first part is how you would actually conduct a site assessment. It'll help you classify the vegetations. It'll talk about slope. It'll talk about setback distances and how you measure that. That's the first thing. So it gives you this methodology on how to come up with this the BAL level. Once we've established what the BAL level is, then we have the BAL rating. Then we have a prescription on how to actually then build a house that's either at BAL 12.5, 19, 29, 40 flame zone. So there's six settings there. There's also a BAL low. So two parts: how to assess it, and then how do we then construct to that level. So that's the first point. And it's very, very descriptive. It's very clear. There is a bit of detail in there, but if you've come up with your BAL 12.5, then you can go to the relevant chapter. It will tell you what your expectations are for your glazing, what the roof system needs to be, what materials you can use for the facade, what about the decking. It's really quite comprehensive. And so that's how it works, the methodology, and then the recipe on how to put a structure together that will match or meet that fire intensity. So does that? I hope that explains it.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. I think it's hard because the Australian standards, of course, are a paid document. So you see this number crop up as a homeowner, and it's like, can't.
So the good news there is that Standards Australia are releasing 3959 for free.
Yay!
It's very good to have as a reference. So they're all obviously acknowledging that, and it's giving the whole community a chance to have a look at it. And I'd encourage anyone who's very interested in the parts. It's not that difficult to go through, but again, a good bushfire practitioner will guide you through that process, and material selection as well. So yeah.
That's brilliant. Thanks, Jeff. I'll have to find the link to that and pop that in the resources. Now, with these bushfires, we saw a rate of spread and we saw ember attacks, I suppose, in ways that people hadn't necessarily experienced before. Can we talk through, you mentioned some of the research that Justin Leonard at the CSIRO has been doing, just in terms of what their impact might be for rebuilding in some of these areas and understanding how to build more resiliently around dealing with that rate of spread and those ember attacks?
So what I might do is I'll connect the construction with those BAL levels. So at BAL 12.5 and BAL 19, we're predominantly looking at ember attack. There's a bit of a radiant heat there, and that I sort of missed that point, is that uh, The BAL rating is a measure of radiant heat flux in kilowatts per square meter, which is just basically, to give you an idea, 5 kilowatts per square meter is a human can withstand it for a very short period of time. 10 kilowatts, a firefighter in full PPE can withstand that for a very, very short period of time. Beyond that, it then escalates. At BAL 29, we have, at 29 kilowatts and above, we have unpiloted ignition of like timber. So it means just through radiant heat alone, you'll get something that will combust. So how that then ties in is BAL 12.5 and 19 are predominantly to deal with ember attacks. So we're screening windows, et cetera. So at those lower levels, that's the expectation of the new dwelling would have good ember protection. There will be some other parts, obviously, largely non-combustible, although there are a number of timbers that can be used at that level. At 29, a very select few of timbers, but we're now starting to see that radiant heat. So, as I said, a bushfire will pull apart a structure through ember attack, through radiant heat, and then through flame contact. So at 29 and 40, we've got pure radiant heat, which is the dominant factor there. And then above 40, we're starting to actually get flame impingement. So we're getting the structure is immersed in flame. And obviously, that's the highest level. So I think to answer the question, a lot of these places may come in the higher ratings. And then that's obviously going to prescribe those higher levels. There's a cost associated with that. And this will be a challenging time for councils, for homeowners. So where once was, I'm probably speaking of like Rosedale, there was the beautiful beach shack that was sort of made out of some sort of fibro. They find the site now is about BAL 40 flame zone. Then obviously there's going to be a decision point there. And the story from 2009 was that some sites, not many, but some sites were very difficult to rebuild. But that'll be the challenge. I think the good news here is that because this has been underway for quite some time, or the 39559 has been around for some time, there are more products that are available. The price is coming down. It's more achievable. People understand the standard, and it's becoming more and more doable at that higher end. But at the lower end, it's pretty straightforward. I think the numbers that are thrown around in terms of cost is that for a 12.5, 19 ember proofing, the glazing is kind of minimal. You're looking at about $10,000 to $15,000 on top of a very standard build. So I hope that's answered the question. But that would be the expectation there.
Yeah, I think that it's really interesting to see, before you and I, in our correspondence before we jumped on this interview, we were talking about how the Australian standards for construction, and this is the standards in most places around the world, they're the minimum that construction needs to adhere to. They're not like the gold standard. They're not the best performance standard. They're the bare minimum of what a home needs to be obviously a shelter. And it's really interesting to see homeowners becoming more and more informed about the need to actually exceed standards in order to have a functioning, performing, durable, long-lasting home that is comfortable and is going to last them for the decades that they want it to. So I'm seeing homeowners actually desiring to build beyond their standards because they understand that, and many feel that we're kind of on the cusp of a realization that these standards need to shift. And there's obviously pushback in other parts of the industry that makes that a little bit slow to happen. But it's quite interesting to see how much this is being led by consumers saying, look, no, actually, I want something better for my home. I want to protect myself and my family and my asset. And I want to understand what's involved in that.
Did you find that helpful? I so hope that you did. Make sure that you check out the description below. We've got lots of extra information to help and support you as you build or renovate your home. There's also a full transcript available of this interview, and the link is in the descriptions below. Now, be sure to like the video, subscribe to Undercover Architect's YouTube channel, and hit the bell so that you're notified every time a new video is published. And you can be sure to check out these videos as well, because we've got lots of extra information to share with you that's going to be super helpful. As always, thank you for tuning in and for letting me be your secret ally. Until next time, bye.